All right, we're on the last chapter for the first test. This is the solutions for chapter 3. There were three problems. The first problem is 3-1, and what you're to do is actually explain the sections of a bond printout that you'd find in a Wall Street Journal. The first thing was the company, and this company was the MGM Mirage, and the bond ticker symbol was MGG. For the coupon, it was 8.50, and what that is the coupon is the annual interest rate of the bond. Remember that a bond has a face value of $1,000, so you multiply that 8.5% by $1,000 and you get $85. So again, 1,000 times 0.085 equals 85. A bond pays in two equal installments, so the bearer of the bond will actually get $42.50 twice a year. As you can tell by the maturity, this textbook's a little bit outdated. This bond actually matured in 2010, and bonds have a face value or have a life of 20 years. So this bond was issued September 15th of 1990, or September 16th, I guess. And the bearer of the bond, the person who holds the bond at the time of maturity, gets $1,000. Again, that's the face value of the bond. The last price in the Wall Street Journal would have 115.90, and what that is that's an abbreviation of $1,159. All you need to do is just multiply that 115.90 times 10, and you get the last trading price. So this bond is trading at a premium. It's trading over $1,000. And the reason why that happens is because the coupon is above the market value of interest for a comparable risk item. The yield is 5.504, that's actually 5.504%, and what that tells us is that if you bought this bond today and held it to maturity, in theory of course, because the bond has already matured, you would earn 5.504% on your investment. And the reason why it's less than the coupon is because you're paying a premium, if you were wondering that. Now, I actually took an entire course as an undergraduate student on calculating that number. So I just want you to know what it is, and we don't need to worry about calculating it. And then we have the estimated dollar volume in thousands. The unit volume is 5,316, so 5,316 bonds were bought and sold on the last trading day. And we multiply that number by 1,000 because the par value of bond is 1,000, and it's estimated that $531,600 was traded the last trading day. 3-2, and please, when you're looking at the way that I'm doing both the stock and the bond, make sure that you do the same, and I'll tell you exactly where most students make mistakes on the test, because one or both of these will be problems on the test. The first one is actually on the first question, and the stock has increased by 4.3% since the beginning of the calendar year. If you say since last year, it could be a 52-week year, it could be the calendar year, it could be a fiscal year, so you need to go ahead and say that it's the beginning of the calendar year. The 52-week high-low, again, students don't put over the past 52 weeks. Sometimes they'll just put the stock at a high of $17.95 and a low of $12.62 and not explain that it's over the past 52 weeks. So those last five words on that sentence will actually either make it right or wrong, as with the last four or five words of the sentence on the year-to-date percentage change. Stock and symbol is Hilton and HLT. Just explain that the company name is Hilton and the ticker is HLT, and you're going to do great there. DIV or dividend, the stock paid 8, it was 0.08, and the stock paid 8 cents in dividends since January 1st of the year. The dividend is from the beginning of the calendar year and not the not 12 months like the 52 week high low. Make sure you put that it's either the calendar year or January 1st, or you'll get that one wrong also. Now on the yield percentage, I also want you to calculate it. So you need to go ahead and tell me what the yield percentage is and how it's calculated. And the yield percentage is actually calculated by taking the dividend and divide it by the close. So you get 0.08 divided by 1786, which is the close, and you get 0.004. 0.004 is the same as 0.4%. So on the yield percentage, I want you to explain to me the formula and show me how to calculate it. And that's the same thing with PE ratio. Now on PE ratio, again, You have a price earnings ratio, which is the close over earnings per share. You're not given earnings per share, but I want you to calculate it. The PE ratio was 32, I believe. And you do your calculation and you get 49 cents for earnings per share. Oops. If you have any questions about that, let me know. I don't know what I just did, but let me get back to where we were. Oops. All right. There we go. On the next question is actually we're continuing on 3Q. I'm sorry. And the volume, you need to tell me that 3,588,800 were traded over the last trading day. Bonds volume, you multiply by 1,000. Stocks volume, you multiply by hundreds. And that's something you're just going to need to memorize. The close is the closing price of the stock on the last trading day. So when the stock exchange closed, I said the last trading day because if today is Monday or if yesterday was a holiday, then it's not going to be yesterday. It'll be the last trading day. It closed at 1786. And then the net change, that's actually what the stock did from the last trading day to the day before the last trading day. So if today is Wednesday, on Monday, the stock was $17.64. And then on Tuesday, the close was $17.86. And going back to PE ratio, the PE ratio in the textbook is 36. So you take 17.86, you divide it by 36, and you get 0.49. Okay, going on to 3.3. We have a bond with a coupon of 7.25% and a yield to maturity of 5.9%. And the bond is selling at 1.15 is the way it's stated in the journal. First thing I would want you to do on this problem is take that present yield to maturity of 5.9% and put a line through it, like I told you a little earlier. You just need to know what yield to maturity is. You don't use it in any calculations, and you don't need to know how it's calculated. So how much would it cost to buy 100 of these bonds? The first thing I do is I go ahead and find out what it costs to buy one. And for one bond, you take the 115, you multiply it by 10, and you get $1,150. Then you multiply 11,150 times 100 for 100 bonds, and you get $115,000. For the part two of this, how much interest would you receive if you had these 100 bonds? First thing I do is figure out how much interest I had with one bond. So you take the par value, which is $1,000, you multiply it by the coupon, which was 0.0725. 7.25% is 0.0725 in a decimal, and you get 7250. And then the interest on 100 bonds would be 7250 times 100, which is $7,250. On the first test, I will assure you that you will have two of these three questions, and somehow, some way, I'm going to go ahead and kind of incorporate all the information in those two of three questions. So you need to know these real well because these will be problems on the first test. You'll have multiple choice, and then you'll have two problems, and the two problems are coming straight from Chapter 3. Good luck on the test, and if you have any comments or questions about the test, email me or call me, and I'll talk to you soon. Take care.